I'd bought a pistol. The first thing after my friend Tom Moss was lynched, because I expected some cowardly retaliation from the lynchers. I felt that one had better die fighting against injustice than to die like a dog or rat in a trap. I'd already determined to sell my life as dearly as possible if attacked. I felt if I could take one lyncher with me, this would even up the score a little bit.
Hey, yo.
Hey, Spell, you made that beat?
Hey, yo. The oldest sibling, hold the dribbling, had to travel when the parents died. Yellow fever gave him seizures, put him under gravel, tears and eyes, back to back, let him share a side. Family ties tried to unravel, like a raffle, when you break the tassel. She was the glue, okay, who kept the fam strong, armed for battle. She was the screw, uh-huh. She got him through, honest. Like a righteous family court judge, disarmed with a gavel. She promised to fight for black merchants, black workers, and the black impoverished too. A star among us, the brightest comet, we pay homage to. But what she did for us when she fought back for Black America. Ida B. Wells told it well with no lack of character. Probably 5'2", but wrote like the hardest rapper. She got lynching off the street, so slide through with no caption. She was mentioned in the street cause she would preach but no pastor. Power in her written speech, like a howitzer shooting at you. Yahweh, Allah Hayim took her up with no rapture. Honest. Sing to him, auntie. Most of her vernacular was trapped in newspaper. It was spectacular how she wrote it, quoted for more views later. Refused favors, did her thing in court before Ruth Bader. Ginsburg. Moved from Memphis to New York, acquired a few new neighbors. Okay. W.E.B. Du Bois, William Trotter and Ida. Started the NAACP. Start the saga, the new genre, a lot to lift. Get a spotter, get photographers to follow. Need to visualize the product, show survivors. Speak truth with our saliva, rebuke the colonizer. Write it down, no falsifiers, black soldiers. Back from war, the tour gave a partial trauma. Caught the drama, the Klan. Lighting flames up like kebabs and carabas. We're in pajamas, we see the cross burn. Son, get the choppers, go get the choppers. They don't listen, spark the llama. Why you do it, cause your honor? Yeah. They brought heat to us, we had to introduce them to the sauna. They were trying to lynch a crime attempt, but God gave us a longer stint. This does not apply to all events, but all events that do involve a lynch. Get them all equipped, then fire back, attack back. That's how we solve defense. Fire till the arm is spent, then hook it to the harness. Fire more back till the harness splits. Fire, then we all repent. They put them black soldiers in jail, without a doubt, without a count. Ida B. Wells appealed in court and got him out. They had to shout. She did it so well, cause that's what she's about. Honest. That's honest. Sing to him, auntie. Sing to him, auntie.
Ida B. Wells was born on July 16, 1862, in Hollywood Springs, Mississippi. She was an American investigative journalist, educator, and early leader in the civil rights movement. She was one of the founders of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, the NAACP. Over the course of a lifetime, she was dedicated to combating prejudice and violence in the fight for African American equality, especially that of women. Wells arguably became the most famous black woman in America. In 2020, Wells was honored with a Pulitzer Prize Special Citation for her outstanding and courageous reporting on the horrific and vicious violence against African Americans during the era of lynching. Ida B. Wells transitioned on March 25th, 1931.